Hey everyone, welcome to this week's edition of WWTT, What Were They Thinking? This is a game between the Boston Bruins and the New York Rangers last week. As you can see, the score is 2-2, heading into the final stages of the game, a minute and 10 left in regulation, and looks like a normal play, the Rangers advancing the puck, trying to score a game-winning goal. Let's see what happens here. So the Rangers have the puck, bounces around a little bit, it goes in the corner, and now for some reason you see Rask starting to leave his net. And he continues to slowly, methodically, and deliberately skate towards the net. And then already you see here a Boston Bruins coach yelling at him, stay, stay. This guy is also starting to get a little concerned. Some of the players are too. We'll get into this in a close-up in a second. Although most of them are looking to make a normal type of line change. Full speed ahead for Chris Kreider. He can jump. So look here, here's Patrice Bergeron. He is the captain of the Boston Bruins, and he's doing captain-like things. He actually takes one hand off a stick and waves at Tuukka Rask, saying, Tuukka, wait, wait, go back to your net. Not sure why you are leaving your net. We still have a minute left, and we are tied. There's no delayed penalty. We are not down by a goal. We do not need you on the bench. We do not need an empty skater. So there you see Bergeron doing the right thing, telling his goaltender to return to the net. But then as you see, Rask skates right by him, basically ignores his captain. I don't know if there's anything else going on. I'm sure there's nothing else going on, but he basically says, no, I am going to the bench and there's nothing that you can do to stop me. Okay, so now we see all five skaters here. Bergeron has kind of gone to the side now that he's been dismissed by his goaltender. Marchand's looping back. And Tuukka Rask, I guess something happened because now he can see him not so quickly. Like, look at him. He's kind of taking his time. He's going back to his net, maybe because he knows that his teammates have the puck. But he's not showing a lot of urgency there. I don't know if he's a little embarrassed or he's just taking a sweet old time. So then Boston retains possession, and they are fine. They clear the puck here. Actually, they don't clear the puck. New York gets a shot. Thankfully, it wouldn't have gone in even if Rask wasn't in the net. And then we see that the time runs down about a minute later. So now Rask takes off his mask. You can tell he's got that, uh-oh, these guys are going to give it to me look. And yeah, he's kind of got that sheepish grin, the same grin that I have when I say something dumb or I'm going to get in trouble from my lovely wife, Gail. But yeah, now he looks up, he looks at the bench, and he's got, that's a good grin. I think you can tell he's happy. He's obviously put the problems of the last year's bubble behind him. He's not bitter, he's not angry. Look at that, that guy looks relaxed, he looks happy. Probably also because Boston is playing so well in the standings, doing so well. So here's what happens. So you see Rask, he actually thinks that they are down by one. So there he goes. You can see some urgency. And then right there, here's the moment, because you know he's not going to skate right into the board. So here's the moment where he realizes, oh dang, I'm not supposed to be heading towards the bench. You see some of his teammates, his Yaroslav Halak telling him, what are you doing? You have another teammate here yelling at him. That might be McAvoy, not sure. He's starting to realize that, no, he should not be here. And this is the moment that he recognizes, I got to turn around and get back to the net. Okay, now let's look at the bench. This part is the most fun to me. Okay, so here's Rask coming here. So remember, he's way back here, but already you can see the coaches starting to notice that something is up. So let's advance it a bit here. So now we have two of the four coaches starting to get ready with their hand signals. They're pointing, they're waving, they're doing the Macarena, whatever they're doing. And here's Bergeron. Remember Bergeron who waved at him? Bergeron is getting ready to get on the ice. And you can see he's looking right at Rask. So he knows what he's going to do as a good captain. So he advanced it a bit. These two coaches are still going crazy. None of the players have really noticed except this guy. This guy is forward Trent Frederick, number 11. And I give him props because he's the first one to stand up. See, boom, he's up and he starts to point with this stick. Meanwhile, Bergeron, look at that. Good captain, has not taken his eyes off of Rask. We advance a little bit more. Now, Frederick is reaching out with a stick. This coach put his arm down. He's tired. This coach is still pointing. This trainer looks like he's ready to say something, but he realizes he's not that loud, behind his mask. So he's going to remove his mask. I'm not sure whose hand this is. Looks a little creepy, actually. The forwards don't really care. They just worry about making a good line change. But now the entire defense has stood up with Frederick leading the way by pointing. And look, Bergeron still, although he's definitely avoiding this Rangers player, still looking at his goaltender. So he advanced it a tiny bit more. Now this guy is waving like crazy. Now more guys are up. Sean Crowley stands up and says, maybe I should get in this too. Pasternak's not sure if he should be watching his forwards or watching Rask come to the net. And then, and this guy doesn't want to stand up. Maybe he just came off after a long shift. But you can see now that everyone is, you have the entire, all the defense standing up. You have some of the forwards standing up. Pasternak's still not sure. There's Bergeron's wave to Rask, you know, the one that Rask ultimately ignores. And then you see finally as the NBC Peacock comes up that Rask is starting to change his skating stance now. Now he's opened up. He's ready to make his pivot and sheepishly head back to the net. And of course, after all that, he needs a swig of Gatorade.